When I was at Yale, I was a mechanical engineer, so I decided to really embrace, like, college kids have furniture that's really, really heavy and it's hard for them to store it. And I started thinking about, like, oh, Legos for furniture would be really, really cool. Come on in. I have lounge chairs, sofas, shelves. We got a register, like, or a bar if you want. But it's all made out of this triple ply materials. It's like your regular cardboard, but it's three layers thick. It's like plywood, but it's a fifth of the weight. And this chair opens just like this. And you can see there's, like, basically I use it doing fold and slots, and everything is like pretty simple assembly. It's pretty much a seat wrap, a top wrap, and sort of like this bottom little mini support wrap thing too, but it's very simple structure design. You can actually understand how the weight is distributed by seeing where the indents are here. And you can make this from like one 4x8 sheet of cardboard, which is a pretty standard size. And then this just plugs in really into like very simple design, so you can kind of see how everything works by looking at it. And through just slots and folds, you can create like a desk chair. You can create a drafting table, sofas, like a workbench, armchair, a shelf, and a standing desk. The rocker chair is pretty fun too. And then a stool.
And a stool. This has to be the first.
I think it's the only store in the country that's everything is made out of cardboard. Or should I say corrugated? But back here is the first chair I ever made out of cardboard. It first started as a senior project. And the idea was that it was gonna be a chair this way and this way too, just for the fun of it. And I was experimenting with this angle here, which actually was not so good because it was tippy. So I figured that out early on. And then this was like a much better angle because it doesn't cut in as much, so your center of gravity is much better for this chair. So the idea with this was that it was like Legos for furniture, and that you could use one piece and it could be reconfigurable from a chair. And then if you rotated it like this, actually there was another piece that kind of came in on top, but this would be like sort of a coffee table. So if you turn the chair on its side, it'd be a coffee table with some shelving. And then if you turn it over again on its end, that it would be this sort of stacking shelf idea. So the idea was to create a central unit that would be reconfigurable and could be made into any of the three furniture parts that you'd have in your college dorm. It even has zip ties on it because I wasn't totally confident in like the strength of cardboard. I wasn't convinced yet, but now I am. From this, what I realized was like people were like, hey, it's cardboard, and it's a chair, shelf, and a table, and you know, it does all those things. And also for me as a design problem, it's much harder to design something really well that is a table, a shelf, and a chair than to just focus on one aspect of the design and design that part really well. So I decided to specialize instead of trying to do everything and sort of designed the chair. So I had, this thing is really good at being a chair. And then this is really, really good at being a shelf. And then this is our table now. So I kind of specialized all the designs, went through a lot of design iteration, and sort of built a whole product line. So you can kind of like sit and rock, and you can see like this becomes maybe like a CD shelf thing or a media system. I like making stuff, and cardboard has been definitely this material I've been sort of obsessed with for a while. These were like little high heel shoes that I made because I was like interested in, oh, like what about disposable footwear? Because I see like girls going out, they're like killing themselves in their high heels and like, forget these, and they just kind of want to throw them away. So I was like, hey, maybe disposable high heel shoes would be cool. I did iPhone cases for a while. It's a beautiful material. It's very simple. It's very available. It's very forgiving because when you make something, it doesn't have to be like totally perfect. So this is one table I made. I wasn't crazy about the design, but I kept it around. But most of my tables are this design here, where you just have like this triangle with legs in it. Triangles are awesome. I love triangles because they're like the simplest sort of geometrical shape, and they sort of balance each other out really nicely. So this is a sofa. This has been probably like 2.5 years, so it's a little creaky, but you can see the indents where people have sat on it. This is like one of the first couches that I made. I think the cool thing about this piece is that if people were first coming in and getting introduced to the idea of cardboard, they'd sit down together. It'd be like the sort of experience, like, oh, it works, it holds up, you know, and people get excited, and then they, once they sit down and they trust it, then they reconsider everything else. And we've had some pretty like heavy people sit on it too, like bouncers that are, you know, clubs that are like 350 pounds. We had like three of them on here one time. So it was like 1,000 pounds on this couch. So that's the cool thing about this piece is it's very efficient. It's made from 1.5 sheets of 4x8. So I was like kind of proud of how I laid out all the materials so that they'd be really efficient to manufacture. But I have all these books, books and books and books from 3 years. With all the designs I've ever had. I mean, here's one of my design notebooks. Here's an architect's drafting table. This is the first sort of angled table. I was like, oh, it doesn't have to be flat. It can be like an angled surface. Here's just more chair iterations. Here's the bed design. I actually made a bed. It was actually too complicated, but a lot of parts. I did a baby changing table. That was fun. Oh, here's a Girl Scout cookie stand that I did. Oh, this is gonna be a picnic bench. No, this is an office cubicle that I did. Oh yeah, this is like at the very beginning, I went to the Yale furniture study. I was looking at different chairs that were inspiring for me. And this is just initial like sort of dimensions. There's the Frank Gehry chair, Frank Gehry cardboard chair, which I liked. And I just took all these ideas and this was like the initial brainstorming. And you can see like, it was like the fourth day of my project. And here was the design I had. And it's very similar to the final design. So it's just triangles. I went through all these different designs. I was looking about hinges, and here's a butt stamp that would like compress the cardboard so it would fit your butt. Each person would have their own butt stamp. But then I went on to like looking at tessellating things, and that's kind of where I started.
Show me your work right in the back.
No, it's right here. This is it.
This is actually where you get stuff done. So what do you have materials?
You can see some of the sheets over there, and I just bring it on the table. I got my, you know, a jigsaw over here for cutting. So yeah, just a saw and ruler, and I got some stencils. I think a lot of it for me is like still trial and error. So it's still a lot of like testing and experimenting and just getting a feel and a sense for the material. I'll make it small scale, like I'll do these little laser cut prototypes. And so this is this piece right here. So before I make it full scale, I'll just kind of take an X-Acto knife and refine the design. And that really allows me to like iterate and evolve really, really quickly. And then once I have a design, I can sort of tweak it and then I can build it full scale. So I was looking at this, I was like, hey, if someone was using the stool, they'd probably want to put their backpack or some storage in here. So really I should have a piece in there that connects this so it makes it a continuous shelf. And you know, maybe this is a little high for most people, so maybe we should make this a little bit lower. And you know, if people keep like sort of leaning back too far, so we need like sort of a backstop. Maybe not like a backrest. Maybe they just need a little bit of a backstop. So what I did for this one is I increased each of these shelves so you have a continuous, you know, shelf for your backpacks here. This one gives you a backstop for you to lean against. And you know, I'd make earlier design decisions just the same way, and then I implemented that full scale. So you can sit on it, put your feet up, and you can like store all your stuff in there. And I've done that for like, you know, my shelves, my tables. And it's kind of fun because they make little like dollhouse furniture things too. This is a stool. You can see metal or wood has to like fit exactly together. So cardboard, it's like, you know, I can be a little bit off and understand it and get the concept across without having to be like, you know, everything has to be perfect. That's back like that. We actually made 2,000 of those for summer camp. So that's pretty cool. The armchair is kind of fun because it was actually inspired from a student. He started off as a mustache chair because it was like for Movember, or it was like No Shave November to support prostate cancer. So I decided to make it like a chair with like sort of look like a mustache with those little curls. It has this like sort of, actually originally it had these pieces that came down here. It came down here and it looked a little like, a little throny. It's too heavy. So I decided to slim it down a little bit more like, more space age, like Captain Kirky. It's a really fun piece. I feel like it's like good for your posture and kind of has some magnitude to it, even though it's just cardboard, so.
It's amazing how strong this stuff is.
Yeah, it's really strong. It's a great material. This is a giant hamster wheel. You can kind of, you know, roll. I think it's really important to like continually be designing and iterating and making new things. I can sit inside of it. You know, it's like a little, nook. If you want to read something, it's a little squish, you know. If you're like nervous about making new things and you have to like send off designs to China or whatever, it kind of like, you know, obstructs the design process. Hardboard, it's like it affords trial and error and design mock-ups and that kind of stuff. Oh, this is a bunk bed. I can actually hold my weight. I slept up there. I've seen a lot of people like making loft beds, and I said, yeah, well, why don't I make like a cardboard bed? Because I feel like that's the ultimate test of strength, you know, to make it hold me. I made a small model first. I just had to like figure out what's a good repeated joint that I can use that it's gonna be strong enough. I kind of figured out this interlocking mechanism. Basically just rectangular prisms that kind of fit together. It's pretty basic, but it works. And it kind of makes like this like, you know, environment that you can live in, and you can, you know, have your desk down here, and then you can kind of sleep up there. I forgot about the ladder part. But then I was like, whatever, do that another time. I think I just wanted to see if I could do it. And our most recent thing was the standing desk. And the cool thing about the standing desk is the first piece that I made that was actually out of single wall. Everything else is made out of this really thick cardboard. This stuff is actually made from single wall, and it was the first product that I was able to sort of mass produce in scale. So we used a big rotary die and we kind of punched these out, versus these I cut off by hand and, you know, one at a time in a CNC machine. And it was a great idea because standing desks cost like, you know, $1,000, and they're so expensive, people want to try them out in their workplace. So this is a great way for them to experiment with standing while working.
What do these cost?
These are $95, including shipping to anywhere in the United States. Oh, look, new order. So you just ordered a standing desk from Oxford, Ohio. I think it's really important. This is like lightweight and ephemeral, sort of not being attached to pieces, but them kind of moving with us and growing and changing with us. The whole idea of like living with less and be less attached to objects and things. So all I basically need to run the business is like my laptop and my iPhone. And so I could be anywhere. This desk lasts like 3-4 years, no problem. And when you're done with it, you recycle it and you don't feel bad about it. I think it's really important. The idea that we're moving around and we can make the furniture when we get there, or we can make furniture from all the moving boxes that we use to move our stuff. So this is a really, really cheap shelving idea to, you know, repeat like a pattern over a large distance. You can just take standard boxes that you get at any shipping store. You can have a combination of larger squares, and this is like 4 small squares make up a big square. You can kind of just stack them together and clip them at the joints, and it's super cheap. All you have to do is clip it together, and you can kind of design your own shelving. I was reading about Buckminster Fuller recently, and he has like this one quote I really like. I'm gonna mess it up a little bit, but it's like, if it's the simplest, most basic elemental design, it's gonna be beautiful. Here, I just have some more origami stuff. I figured if my name is Chairigami, I should be at least adept at origami. You don't have to try and make it beautiful. If you've done everything you can to whittle it down, it should be beautiful. This is a lampshade made out of ketchup things. You know what I like about it? That is, I was like, oh man, it's like not a perfect sphere. But then it's really nice because it's like this weird, you know, rugby ball shape, and I love that it's not symmetrical. Yeah, you put a light inside, that's where the hole is there. And it kind of looks cool. Yeah. So that's that. So this is the first sort of cushion prototype that I made. I never really followed up on it, but I just kind of cut into this piece of corrugated, like a little bit, and then stuffed in, I think we had like this old snow, like fake snow from Christmas. And then I took this pretty ugly piece of fabric and then folded over and stuck it in and made it sort of like an upholstery. People, when they buy things, they kind of just, oh, you know, I'll buy this and I'll assume that it works and I'll assume that it was made exactly for me, but I'm not gonna really think about what the materials are made from, the manufacturing process, assembly, all that kind of stuff. I'm just kind of like, kind of have it. But I think the way this is designed, it immediately encourages you to say, hey, oh, this is what it's supporting my foot, because this line continues here and it's just one material. So it kind of just invites questions and like, oh, hey, this is all made out of cardboard. How is it holding me up? How is it structurally sound? And it kind of leads you through this 20 questions, and I think through that you might apply that to other pieces of furniture and the way you think about design. And the other thing is, like, you can hack them like really easily. Like, you can, you know, cut holes here if you want to put your power cord. This whole thing is like a hollow kind of conduit. Even the box, you can take the box that it comes in and you can add another layer to the top. Actually, this one, I took the standing desk and I cut off the legs so it could be like a regular desk. But we've had people put like speakers in it. We've had people paint it. And this chair is covered with duct tape. Some people think it's painted, but it's actually just duct tape strips, you know. And actually, it's really nice because it strengthens that outer layer and also has like a waterproof kind of thing for it. So it's a fun way to decorate your chair. So it's really kind of like this open source thing where you can just, you know, make it your own, personalize it. A transducer speaker that's like inside the table, and it's stuck under this piece of cardboard. So if I put this mat over it, it's actually using the cardboard as the speaker. If it was wood or metal, it'd be a lot harder for someone to kind of do these like small little tweaks. But with cardboard, you can just, you take an X-Acto knife and you can do anything you want. This is like me and my friends kind of like jamming.
And
also people start thinking about not only, hey, I'll just buy this product and have it, but how can I use this as a jumping off platform to start designing like what my house is going to look like, what my office is going to look like, and then take that into their own hands. They become like their own engineers, you know?
The other thing I love is also that he can move the furniture himself, you know? I like that.
He loves it too.
It's like none of this like metal furniture stuff. Yeah? Okay, ready? So the first step is you fold the triangle in half, like this. Flip it over. So do that. Okay, now fold it in half so it's like a hamburger. Like this. So two corners.